My name is John Hart. I'm director of jazz guitar at University of Miami's Frost School of Music. I teach private lessons. I'm also directing ensembles. I run the Guitar Ensemble 1, and this year I'm directing the Monk Mingus Ensemble, and I started a new ensemble, which I'm directing, the Wayne Shorter Ensemble. I've been very blessed to do a lot of interesting things as a musician in the last 30 years. I've worked and recorded as a leader. I was thrilled to get a record deal with Blue Note very early in my career. I did 2 records for them. I also recorded for Concord during the 90s, and I've also probably done 100 plus CDs with other artists. I spent 16 years with Jack McDuff on and off. I played with him up to the time he died, and that was really a great experience for me to be with him. I probably did about 9 or 10 records with him. I've also worked a lot with some of the more contemporary artists. I had a collaboration with Chris Potter for about 7 years. We had a quartet together. We recorded 2 records for Concord. I also played on a couple of his records. I played with and Brian Blade's band for a couple years, the early 2000s, and that was a great experience. And used to play with Larry Goldings a lot. And then besides that, just many great artists in New York. I've been blessed to play with jazz greats from the bygone eras to all the younger players, and it's, as I say, I feel very blessed. After I finished school, I basically moved to New York pretty shortly after, maybe a year after. I went on the road for a band, and I realized that I was pretty much prepared for any type of gig. I could read really well. I knew harmony inside and out. That was all stuff that I had learned when I was in school here. I was still developing my own sound as a player and stuff, but all the fundamentals were there. I would even meet musicians from other parts of the country, and you know, I'd show them some of the harmonic things I was working on, and they were like, "Where did you learn that?" And it's like, "Well, I learned it at school in Miami." One of the things I think that's great about Frost is their teachers are here, so we all live in Miami, and everybody's busy. You know, everybody gets called to go on the road and tours, so it's tricky, but it's very important for me to be here for my students. Sometimes a short tour will happen, like right during a break or something. That makes it a lot easier. I actually had 2 recordings recently where both leaders scheduled it so they could be on the weekend, so I could fly to New York for it. So all those kind of things, you know, it's a balancing act, but it's very important for us all faculty to be here for our students. Biggest advice I think I would have for a young musician is you learn from all your heroes, but try to find that thing inside you that makes you unique. I think that's what's going to really sustain you over the long haul. And everybody has it. You know, we're all unique people, and that's what all the greats from the past have done. They've taken their influences and made their own sound out of that. I think if you're true to what you really believe and what you feel in your heart as a musician, and you're honest about that, I think your audience is going to come to you. Frost is a very special place. I was a student here 30 years ago, and Frost has always attracted great talent and student body. I knew that when I was in school here, and that hasn't changed through the years. But I think the school offers even more opportunities as it's grown, particularly in terms of not only from a player standpoint, but from composition and arranging, and there's so many different directions the students can go here. I think any student that comes here is going to find it not only challenging, but a very inspiring place to be.